Hi, my name is Tom, and you are at level 30 in Mastering Einstein's Special Relativity. This level is about the space-time interval, another universal truth for all observers. This is the B level, and to be honest, I think the B level is more intuitive than the A level, so let's get into it. So the space-time interval, it's real, and therefore we can be happy. What is it? Well, let's say we have two events, and we have two different observers, and both observers measure location and time of these events. Then they can do some mumbo-jumbo by calculating the distance between these two events in space-time. Not in space, not in time, but in the the interconnected space-time fabric. And then they get the space-time interval. So we know that if you only look at time and only look at location, both observers will not agree upon where things are, when they happened, how far apart they are in time or space, but they do agree about the space-time interval between the two events. I'm going to show you an equation. Keep breathing, because I will visualize it in a bit and then you will immediately understand it, but it looks like this. Space-time interval has its own character, S squared. It's not the square of anything, but someone thought it would be good to have the label S squared in there, although it doesn't really have to do anything with a square. I will tell you in the C level, but for now, the space-time interval is the square of C delta T squared minus the square of delta X. So you could say it's a bit like Pythagoras. It's the difference in time squared minus the difference in location squared. And you need to have, of course, the speed of light somewhere in there, because this is special relativity. And when different observers apply this equation to the same two events, they always will get the same answer. It doesn't depend on where or how fast each observer is going. And that's what makes it a universal truth. But let's play with it in the one-dimensional space-time diagram. I built this online. You can go there. Here is the link. Just follow me and I will talk you through. Let me see if I can switch my screen. Yes. There it is. The space-time diagram. What do we see? I have a dotted red line, which is observer number one, the stationary one. I have a dotted blue line, which is observer number two. I wouldn't be surprised if this observer is traveling at 80% of the speed of light. So there he goes. And here we have two random events while being in the perspective of observer one. This is event number one. It happened at a specific time and location through the eyes of observer one, and the same for observer two. And if you now calculate the space-time interval here in the red, you take this length, the difference between the two events on the vertical axis, which is the CT axis, and you square it, and you subtract the difference along the horizontal, which is the X coordinate. And you can see, if I take myself out, that's the X coordinate. And that results in 676 minus 361 is 315. So in this case, the space-time interval for these two events is 315. We as viewer are now in the perspective of observer one. So we would get exactly the same formula. But look at observer two. Observer 2 has different opinion about the delta time and the delta location here, but he still ends up with 315. And if you want to see for Observer 2 why this is this what it is, here is the perspective slider. You can go there with your mouse, click it, and drag it all the way down, and we are changing our perspective from Observer 1 to Observer 2. Boom! There we are in the perspective of Observer 2. From that perspective, CT squared is 324, and the difference along the x-axis squared is just 9. But again, the equation will end up at 315. So no matter which perspective you are, even if I'm somewhere in between the two perspectives, I'm now in between Observer 1 and 2, you, as a viewer, will have these numbers. If you would take your how do you call this, your meter stick or something, you know, and put it on the screen, and you do the math, you square it and you subtract it, you will get 315, no matter which perspective we are. Do you see how great is this, I mean, this animated space-time diagram is? In this case, Observer 2 is running at 80% of the speed of light. I can even change, I want to prove it to you. I'm going to drag event 2 to somewhere else. I don't care where. Somewhere here. And I'm going to drag event number 2 somewhere over here. So now apparently the space-time interval is what? It's a negative number. You know, that's no biggie. I mean, space-time intervals can have negative numbers. That's fine. You don't have to worry about it. It's not something that always has to be greater than zero. So the interval part of it, you know, is maybe a bit confusing because it can have a negative value. But again, it's minus 99 for all observers. We, Observer 1, Observer 2, and no matter what we do, it will stay minus 99. So this is space-time interval for you, and you can go online and do this yourself. We go back to this one. Yeah, there we are. So this is it. You've mastered the space-time interval. You've actually seen the equation, and you can do it with your ruler on screen on the internet. If you want to know more about special relativity, I've made many videos building up the mathematics and the physics all the way up to this level. Here are the first 18. Pause the video if you want to see. And here are the second batch all the way up to the twin paradox in level 34. This was the B level for space-time interval. If you want to actually see how the equation for the space-time interval can be derived from the Lorentz transformation, then you will have to see the C level. If you just want to follow the headlines, you can follow the green episodes here. I want to thank you for watching and hope to see you next time.